A contour integral along a simple closed contour C equals 0 if f is analytic on an inside C. This does not depend too much on C, of course. You can draw many curves C in a given domain such that f is analytic on an inside C. But this is holds for all curves in a given domain. Well, only if there are no holes in the domain. This property of a domain is called simply connected. We'll learn in this video what this precisely means. So domain D is called simply connected if every closed contour within D only encloses points of D. So you draw some closed contour inside D, and then inside your contour you can only have points of D. This should hold for all contours. So let's look at the figure. First region, the first domain, is simply connected. This domain over here. It's the interior of the green egg. Well, why is it simply connected? Well, try to draw any simple closed contour. I drew the yellow one here. And we look inside and we see indeed inside there are only points of D. So it's fine. And you see from the domain already, it doesn't matter how you draw your yellow contour. Any closed contour will only enclose points of D. Then we look at the second region, the second egg, where some small part is missing, as you see. Well, we can draw the same contour, the yellow one over here, and there we are fine, because inside the yellow one there are only points of D. However, we can also draw another contour, the red one over there, and you see if you look inside the red one, well, there are a few points of D, but there are also points that do not belong to D, which means that the second region is not simply connected. Well, you see it, of course, already, it has a hole. So that's why it's not simply connected. Then, if your region is simply connected, then we are happy because we have our theorem 1. If f of z is analytic, so it is simply connected domain D, then this integral is 0 for every closed contour C in D. And why is that? Well, if you draw any closed contour, then your function will be analytic inside your contour, because inside your contour those points are in the domain D, and then there your function is analytic, so you can apply Cauchy-Gaussat. So if your domain is simply connected, then it doesn't matter how you draw your contour, your integral will always be zero. And a small consequence, of course, because your integral along any closed contour will be zero, we had this theorem that f of z has an antiderivative throughout D. Well, it's not given explicitly what it is, but you know f of z has an antiderivative. Just the theorem doesn't tell you how to find it. Well, let's do a small example. We have this horribly looking integral over here, where our C can be any closed contour in the region where the norm of z is smaller than 2. So we have drawn this circle over here, the green circle. So our C can be any closed contour inside this green circle, for example, the yellow one over there. However, if we take a look at the function, we see that it has two singularities at z squared plus 9 equals 0, so z equals plus or minus 3i over there and over there. But they are outside our region, so that means that our f of z is analytic on and inside our domain D, which is simply connected, which means that we can conclude automatically that our integral is just 0.